Hi everyone, welcome back to another Stitchmastery tutorial. Today we are going to talk about the key and different ways you might want to edit this key. The first thing you might want to do is change one of the entries. Now, I showed you in the video about customizing your stitch library, how you can permanently change what shows up here, but there are plenty of times where you just might want a one-off change. For example, with this SSK, you might want this to be a slip knit, pass the slip stitch over, which can be abbreviated as SKP. So to do that, you just move your mouse cursor over to the text, and if you click once and then click again, you can edit the text. So you can simply change that to SKP. Or maybe because these stitches are only used on the wrong side of this chart, you only want to show the wrong side instruction. So again, we just click and you can just delete that whole right side instruction. We could even change this to an SSP. And maybe we want to do the same thing for the knit two together. So that's how you edit the actual text of the key. Now, of course, this also works for the key itself. Maybe you would like to change this to legend. Okay, so we've changed the text in the actual key and we've changed the title of the key. Now, when your stitches show up in the key, they show up in the order that you put them in the chart. But you might wish to have them appear in a little bit more of a logical order. So, for example, I might wish the decreases to be together. You can just click on the square and then you can drag. And you can see it reorders the list. So then let's put our increases together. And then let's actually just change this to a make one. Now, the other thing you can do is change the layout of the key. So if you go to the top menu and you select key and then edit key properties, you'll see that you can also change the key title there. So we could put it back to key, and then you can change the layout. So single row looks like that, or you could have multiple columns. And you can select the number of columns, you can choose whether to make them equal width or not, and then that's what that looks like. So let's go back to a horizontal layout. So by default, the key is on the right-hand side of all the charts. You might want to put your key in a different placement. So what you want to do is just click outside of the key and you'll see it changes to the crosshairs and gives you this selection tool. So if you just select all of the key, click and hold down and you'll be able to drag it, and then you could move it, say, under the chart. And if you wanted to put things back, if you click the tool next to the select, it puts it back. Now, maybe you have a lot of charts in your pattern and they're going to be on different pages in your pattern, and so you actually need the chart multiple times. What you want to do is use the select tool and hit select key, and then when you export as an image, so we'll just call that key. Now you can export the key entries as individual files, but I'm going to keep them as one big file. So what this will do is it's only going to export what we selected. So you can see it's exported just the key. So this is really useful if you need to put the key in multiple places on your pattern, or if you want a little bit more control of where things go in your pattern and not just use the layout that Stitchmastery gives you. So that's a few different ways that you can customize the key in Stitchmastery. I hope you found this helpful. If you did, please hit that like button and be sure to subscribe to my channel. I do new videos every week and there'll be tons more of Stitchmastery tutorials coming your way. If you have a suggestion for more tutorials that you'd like to see, please leave me a comment or you can send me an email, hello@joelicreates.com. I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.